Hello everyone. In the roller coaster of life, sometimes we all need a helping hand. If you are passionate about achieving success, check out our book, The Singing Panda, in the description below. This book will not let you give up and will guide you towards your goal and success. And now, let's begin with our video. Hello and welcome to TFC. I'm Naveen. Science is the search of truth. Since humanity came into existence, we all have been looking up at the sky, searching for what is above and beyond, searching for truth. A long time ago in India, a small group of scientists humbly began their search beyond the sky, carrying parts of rockets in bicycles and also using bullock carts for space experiments. Who would have thought in just few decades this small startup will make history? 24th September 2014, India shocked the world as India's satellite Mangalyaan, after traveling for 10 months in space, entered Mars orbit, thus becoming the first country to reach Mars on its maiden attempt, while Russia had to face 9 failed missions before reaching Mars. Now, the world knows this space agency as Indian Space Research Organization or ISRO. To understand the journey of ISRO, let's turn back time. 1957, launch of the first satellite, Sputnik 1, by the USSR, inspired the world towards space. The next year, America launched Explorer 1, and in 1962, the first British and Canadian satellites were also launched. The same year, in between this nascent satellite race and the ongoing India-China war, the Indian National Committee for Space Research, INCOSPAR, was set up, which later became ISRO, with a motive to harness space technology for national development. At that time, a small fishing village was selected as an ideal location for INCOSPAR experiments, as it was located on Earth's magnetic equator. But there was a problem. Within this area stood a large church, the Church of Mary Magdalene. Vikram Sarabhai, the chairman of INCOSPAR, along with a young scientist, APJ Abdul Kalam, attended the Sunday Mass in that church. At that time, the bishop told everyone, "Scientists also do the work of God for human prosperity," and he went on to ask the followers, "Do they want to give up their church for science?" There was silence, and then everyone replied, "Amen." This is how a church became ISRO's first workplace, and because of this gesture by the villagers, 2 new churches and a school were built for them in less than 100 days. Later, in 1963, the launch of the first sounding rocket marked the beginning of the Indian space program. The next year, in 1964, US demonstrated the power of satellites by the live transmission of Tokyo Olympic Games across the Pacific. But at that time, India's satellite program was almost non-existent. It took 11 years when ISRO's first Indian satellite, Aryabhata, was launched by the Soviet Union. 4 years later, in 1979, India's first experimental satellite launch vehicle, SLV-3, took off, but only 317 seconds later, the vehicle crashed into the Bay of Bengal. All scientists were shattered, but the next year, SLV-3 launch was successful, and Rohini satellite became the first satellite successfully launched by India. Both these launches were headed by India's former president, APJ Abdul Kalam. Now, India has come a long way and has one of the largest operational remote sensing satellites in the world. Not only that, India also holds the record of launching 104 satellites in a single rocket, massively beating the previous record of 37 satellites held by Russia. Now, ISRO, through its commercial entity, Antariksh Corporation, has launched over 300 satellites for 33 countries. So, without any further delay, let's start our never-before-seen journey to witness ISRO's business and space empire. Our first stop is North America, and we will reach the picturesque Canada. ISRO has till date launched 13 satellites of Canada, which includes satellites for communications, managing marine transportation, and the world's first space telescope for asteroids, NEOSAT. Moving to US, we will reach Washington DC, headquarters of NASA, which is the world's richest space agency, having over 12 times more annual budget than ISRO. NASA and ISRO have a history of space Space Corporation. The first Nike Apache rocket launched in India was supplied by NASA. Moreover, in 1970s, ISRO and NASA conducted a joint satellite instructional television experiment site that beamed informational television programs to more than 2,400 villages across India through NASA's satellite. Arthur Clarke, the writer of the iconic 2001 Space Odyssey, called SITE as the greatest communication experiment in history. SITE programs included shows like Krishi Darshan, which was also initiated by Vikram Sarabhai and is now the longest running television show in the world. Moreover, NASA and ISRO have also been jointly involved in the discovery of water molecules on the moon's surface and are now jointly building the world's most expensive Earth imaging satellite, NISAR, to understand the occurrence of earthquakes and other natural disasters. Not only that, ISRO has also launched over 230 American satellites into orbit. From US, let's travel to South America and reach Guiana Space Center. This is a special place for ISRO. From here, around 20 ISRO satellites have been launched, including India's first indigenous communication satellite, Apple. Moving to the rest of South America, ISRO has launched the first satellite built in Chile, the second Colombian satellite, and also a nano satellite built by University in Argentina. From here, let's travel to Africa and reach Algeria. ISRO has launched multiple agricultural and disaster monitoring satellites for Algeria. Moreover, ISRO also holds mission tracking ground station in Mauritius and is also planning another tracking station in the island nation of Sao. Now let's travel to Europe and reach France. The study of the tropical atmosphere in 2011 and studying of ocean in 2013 were some of the missions ISRO and CNES of France had jointly undertaken. Moreover, there are also plans for another joint Earth observation mission called Trishna. ISRO has till date launched three French satellites, including a nano satellite for researching the planet Beta Pictoris b. Furthermore, Russia and ISRO have had a long association, including first Indian satellite Aryabhata was launched by Russia for free, a joint student satellite YouthSat, and also the iconic Indo-Soviet manned space mission when Rakesh Sharma became the first Indian to travel to space. Moreover, the astronauts for India's first manned space mission will also be trained in Russia. In all, ISRO has launched satellites for over 15 European countries, including over 10 satellites for UK and Germany, 5 satellites for Italy, and has also launched the first Austrian satellite, Finland's first educational satellite, and also a Belgian satellite, Proba, which has become ESA's longest operated Earth observation mission. Now it's time to travel to Asia. ISRO has launched multiple satellites for Singapore, South Korea, Israel, Japan, and Indonesia. Moreover, ISRO also holds a joint mission tracking station at Indonesia and Brunei. Moreover, for South Asia, ISRO has launched a SAARC satellite, a gift from India to all its neighboring SAARC countries. Now, after our world tour, finally, it's time to reach India. Here, ISRO centers are located in over 15 locations, which include Vikram Sarabhai Space Center at Thumba and Satish Dhawan Space Center at Sriharikota. Over the years, ISRO has been a major catalyst for the expansion of television in India. ISRO operates one of the largest domestic communication satellite systems in the Asia-Pacific region, which relay 33 Doordarshan TV channels and also DTH like Tata Sky. Moreover, ISRO satellites are also used in multiple fields, including agriculture, water management, land planning, and also disaster management. Furthermore, ISRO satellites also provide navigation assistance to aircrafts, and ISRO has also developed a regional navigation system, NAVIC. In 1999, during the Kargil War, India had approached US to get GPS data of the Kargil region, but that request was denied. This made India realize the importance of a navigation system, and thus, after two decades of hard work by ISRO, NAVIC came into existence. Now, NAVIC at India level is estimated to be more accurate than GPS, and therefore, multiple phones are being launched in India that will be using NAVIC. Moreover, ISRO was also involved in Mission Shakti, a joint mission to successfully test anti-satellite weapon and has also successfully tested the Game Changer rocket, the reusable launch vehicle. We have discussed a lot about space. Now let's travel to space. For our space mission, we will use ISRO's biggest rocket, GSLV Mark 3. As we reach the equatorial orbit, we will be greeted by AstroSat, India's first multi-wavelength space observatory dedicated for research on neutron stars and black holes. Going ahead, we will find the clusters of ISAT and GSAT satellites transmitting television channels, telecom, and VSAT ATM connectivity across India. From here, let's travel towards the moon. In 2009, just 100 kilometers from moon's surface, Chandrayaan 1 was orbiting. Now, we will also find Chandrayaan 2 orbiter circling and the remains of Chandrayaan 2 Vikram lander, which traveled for over 383,000 kilometers, but only lost control just 2.1 kilometers away from the lunar surface. As even after failures, one should never give up. ISRO will again be back on moon with Chandrayaan 3 mission expected to launch in 2021. From moon, let's travel towards the largest object in our solar system, Sun. We will travel for about 1.5 million kilometers from Earth and reach L1, where ISRO has planned Aditya L1 mission, India's first solar mission. From here, let's travel to Venus. ISRO's Venus orbiter mission, Shukrayaan 1, is planned to be launched after 2020. Coming back closer to Earth, ISRO has planned India's first human spaceflight program, Gaganyaan, which will use a half-humanoid called Vyomamitra, which means a space friend, instead of using animals like Laika dog, the first mammal in space, which was used in Sputnik 2. Now let's move towards the red planet, Mars. Here, we will find ISRO's Mangalyaan orbiting Mars and taking images of a very large shield volcano, Olympus Mons, which is about 2.5 times bigger than Mount Everest. As we are now far away from Earth, watching the beauty and wonder of Mars, my mind goes back to the start of this journey, how it all started about 57 years ago by carrying rocket parts on a bicycle to ISRO, now reaching Mars. Who knows what marvelous achievements the next 57 years might bring. All I can say, this is ISRO's business and space empire.